Creeper World 4. Is it worth a buy? Is it? Let's read the words of the developer. The unstoppable fluid enemy has returned and destroyed every world in its path. Defend against Creeper as it floods across the 3D terrain in this real-time strategy game where the enemy is a fluid. Yes, guys, this game began life as a browser game 15 or so years ago, and it's now in full-blown 3D. And that changes a lot. That if you're used to playing Creeper World 1, 2, and 3, well, you'll be pleasantly surprised when you play Creeper World 4 because it's now fully 3D, which changes quite a lot of things, especially the placing of structures and things, because you can see everything in a 3D world. And there's also something really cool being added, waves. Oh yeah, you are fighting against the blue goo, guys. It's like a gooey, globules of blueness. And if it touches anything, it will kill it. It like erodes things away very, very quickly. And you have to stop it with awesomeness of firepower. Just shit tons of mortars, rockets, aircraft, Gatling guns, you name it, you can fire it at it. Well, you can't. You can just fire at it, what I just told you. Stop exaggerating, Mac. First up, the story, guys. It's awful. The story's awful, and it's presented in a really awful way. Just some text on the screen. Oh, that'll f***ing do. What's the story? Someone goes back in time, and then he gets lost, and he's trying to stop the creeper, and he's jumping from planet to planet to planet. There's the campaign. We'll have 20 planets, 20 maps. Bob's your Andy. There you go. So I hope you understand the story. Who cares about the story? We're only here for the actual gameplay because it's the gameplay that's getting this game 96% overwhelmingly positive on Steam, guys. So anyway, how do you play? Well, you start off by placing your central hub, or you might already have it placed for you depending on the design of the map. You then put pylons around your central hub, which will create a little bit of power. Each one will create a little bit of power. So the more you put down, the more power you get. You need power to build shit. So you get all these pylons down early. You might find some natural resources you can use. If the ground's like light colored blue, you can place miners down there and you can mine resources. You might see rock formations like red ones or white ones. They're special rocks that you can mine as well for resources. There's green stuff that you can put a refinery next to. I don't know the names of all of these things, because to do that I would have had to research it, and that might look as if I'm a professional reviewer, and we don't want that. So we'll call it green shit, white shit, red shit. That's my kind of language, guys. So you mine the green, white and red shit, and that gives you shit that you've mined, which you need shit to do shit with. You use shit to shoot, shit to build, shit to power. So there's a lot of fucking shit going down here in this game. You need all the shit you can get. As you spread out far and wide, so is the goo. Oh yeah, the goo's coming, guys, it's coming. The goo's, you can't stop it. The goo's coming, the goo is coming. And you look over that map and you just see the goo getting deeper and deeper and deeper, and it's coming, guys. And you've got to get your defences, you've got to try and get as much of the map under your control as possible early on, then shore up them defences for when the goo hits. And then if you can hold it and stop it in its tracks, you can then consolidate and then start building up your mortars, your machine guns and all that, and start pushing it back. But you've got to keep all your guns supplied with ammo coming from your central hub again. You put factories down to process the raw materials into ammunition and get that sent to the front lines through your little spiral of network things, or you can build pylons which make it go there a lot faster, but they're a lot slower to build, so early doors you can't build them, and it becomes a bit of a franticness, guys. And then you eventually start pushing it back, and it's a battle of attrition as the waves is just hugely high in front of you. It's just awesome as you just creep forward pushing it back, and then you come to the sources of where it's actually coming from. All the creeper has a source where it's coming from, and you nullify that with a special weapon. But placing that weapon, you've got to get it really close, and it's hard to do that. You've got to fight like shit to get it all pushed back, then you nullify it, and then you move on to the next one and complete the objectives and get off the map. And that's the game, guys. Didn't sound that exciting, Mac. Well, it is, all right, it's fucking good. I like it. It's a bit tower defensey with a difference. And the maps are very well designed. And it also has a map editor, guys. And I had a go. There's my map. Isn't it beautiful? Mac, it looks like that was built by a 4-year-old. Yeah, it's just some steps, but I just did it to see if I could make big, deep waves. Big, deep waves of goo, and I did. And there's big, deep waves of goo. And it took me 30 minutes to beat it, and I quite like it, so there, so go away, haters. But there's a lot of maps that was built by people who aren't 4-year-old. They're quite good as well. And there's also a shit ton of developer maps in there as well, about another 20 maps in there. There's loads of stuff in this. It's a £20 game. There is a demo on Steam if you want to try it out first. I wish all games had demos. Remember when all games had demos? Remember the good old... Shall we talk about the good old... Mac, just shut up. Anyway, guys, that's it for this year. I'm thumbing this up because why wouldn't I? It's a tower defense and it's fun. But this is the last review of the year. The next videos will be game of the year, worst game of the year, and possibly a review of the year. And then I'll probably get banned. So it's been nice knowing you. Have a nice life, and I'll see you later.